In this video, we cover the first analysis steps towards clustering cells and finding marker genes. So the topics I will be talking about is how to create a Seurat object, how to filter genes, how to check the quality of cells, and if there are problems, how to filter out low quality cells. So what will you learn during this video? Well, after listening to this video, you should know what kind of input files can be used, what is the structure of a 10x genomics matrix file, how to filter out genes, and how to check the quality of cells and filter out bad ones.
The very beginning of any data analysis, getting the input data in right format, is often the most trickiest and time-consuming part of the analysis. In Chipster, we try to make it as easy as possible, but please pay close attention to the data format. So let's start with the input file options. You can start the analysis with one of these three input files. Either you can give the 10x genomics output files in a tar package. We'll take a closer look at those files in a moment. Or you can give a HDF5 output file from the 10x genomics cell ranger. That file would be ending with the H5. Or a digital gene expression matrix generated, for example, with the DropSeq tools in Chipster, or downloaded from GEO or given to you by your colleague. This file has to have the genes as rows, cell barcodes as column names, and it needs to be in a tab-separated TSV format. This is all explained in more detail in the tools manual page. Let's take a little bit closer look at the 10x genomics output files.
So essentially you have three files and they need to be named like this. So there is the matrix file, barcodes and features, which used to be called genes in the older cell ranger versions. So the main file is the matrix file, where you have the information of the number of UMIs or transcripts for a given gene in a given cell. The matrix is a sparse matrix, which means that only the non-zero entries are stored to make the file smaller. And here we have a beginning of one matrix file. So first there is a header. It's three lines, and the third line is the interesting one. So here we first have the number of lines in the genes file. So essentially, this is the number of genes. Then you have the number of barcodes, so essentially the number of cells. And then finally, the number of lines in the matrix file itself. After these three lines come the actual information. So here you have, in this column, you have the gene index. So we go to the features file and check which entry corresponds to this number. So here in the features file, we have the identifier for a gene, the gene name, and there would also be a type, so a gene expression in our case. Now, if we continue on this line then, so first we have the index of the gene, then we have the index of the cell. So we go to the barcode file and check there what cell this corresponds to. And then finally, we have the number of UMIs. So this number here tells how many transcripts we detected for this gene in this cell. It's important to remember, so you will actually get two folders and you need to take the one which has filtered barcodes rather than the raw barcodes. So filtered essentially means that we only have those cell barcodes that are actually present in your data, because otherwise you end up with this enormous matrix with all the possible barcodes that exist.
Here, we have imported the three 10x genomics output files into Chipster. You can see in the names that this one is the features.tsv, this is the matrix, and this is the barcodes. In Chipster, you can select these files and find the tool Make a tar package and use that to make the tar package that can then be used as an input option for the setup tool. So in the parameters tab of this Seurat version 4 setup and QC tool, we have these parameters here. You can give a project name that will be used in the plotting. You can choose in how many cells a gene is required to be expressed in order to keep that gene. This parameter is very important when you have several samples. So in that case, it's crucial that you name the sample in this field. Please don't use any special characters in the naming as it might disrupt the code. And here below in the input file section, it is important that you assign the files correctly. So if you have the digital expression matrix in TSV format, make sure you choose this option.
When you run the tool, you get two output files. One of them is R object and the other one is a PDF file. So here you can see them. So this R object is a special file. It's actually a Seurat object in this case, and it's a special data structure that the Seurat-based tools use for storing different kinds of data. So it has specific slots for different types of data, and in Chipster you use this file as the input for the next analysis tool. So the data, the actual data, and whatever you add to it or the analysis tools add to it is stored here. You cannot view this file in Chipster, but you just give it as input to the next tool. Of course, if you use R, you can always import it in R. But the interesting file for you now at this point is the PDF file, which contains the quality control plots. There we have different terms, so which can be a bit confusing. But so we have the number of expressed genes in a cell. This is called N feature RNA. There is also the number of transcripts in a cell, N count RNA. And then there is the percentage of mitochondrial transcripts, percent MT. And so these names are now from Seurat version 3 that Chipster uses. Seurat version 2 had slightly different naming for these things. So now let's look at these plots then. So the whole point here is that we are checking the quality of the cells. Remember that in this kind of droplet-based single cell system, what we want to have is we have one cell in one droplet, and that one cell should be a healthy, happy cell. Now, it can happen that there's actually no cell in a droplet. We might still get some signal from this droplet if there is some ambient RNA floating around, but typically the number of genes expressed, so to say, in this, so to say, cell would be very low. And the default threshold that is often used is 200. So here we have violin plots. So every black dot here is a cell. And here we have the number of expressed genes that we detected per cell. So you can see that the majority of cells are sitting here, just a bit below 1,000. But then there are some cells which have very low number of expressed genes, and these are the potential empties. Now, on the other hand, it can happen that several cells end up in one droplet. So perhaps two cells, so then we have a doublet, or even more cells when we have a multiplet. And this is also a problem because we only want one. So the way to detect this is again to look at the number of genes expressed. And here the default threshold is 2,500. So again, if we go to this plot here, we can see that yes, the majority of cells are here, but then there are some cells which are really high up here. So these are the potential multiplets. Now, it could be that we have one cell in a droplet like we should, but then that cell is broken or dead. The way to recognize that situation is to look at the percentage of mitochondrial transcripts. So how big percentage of all the transcripts in a cell are actually mitochondrial? And so why is this related to the happiness of the cell? Well, if the cell is broken or even dead, the normal transcripts have probably degraded already, while the mitochondria, because it's a separate structure, the mitochondrial transcripts might still be more available or intact, and hence the percentage of the transcripts of mitochondrial origin can be high. So here we have that plot. So now on the y-axis we have the percentage of mitochondrial transcripts, and you can see that for most cells this percentage is like 2.5, but then you have some cells which are really high up here, and it's very likely that these are broken cells or even dead cells. So what we want to filter out in the next stage is these ones here, these ones here, and these ones here. And so this is the tool where you would do it. This tool actually does many other things as well, which we will discuss later, but now let's focus on these three parameters here. So here, precisely, you say how you want to get rid of the empties. So what is the threshold? How many expressed genes a cell must have in order to be kept? And you also want to get rid of multiplets. So you want to get rid of cells which express more than this many genes. And finally, you want to get rid of the dead cells too. So the default value for the mitochondrial transcript percentage is 5. Now there was another plot that I skip. So this is basically using the same information, just plotting it differently. So here we have scatter plots. In the first one here, we have the percentage of mitochondrial transcripts versus number of transcripts. Here we want to see, are they actually cells which might have a small number of transcripts in total, and then high percentage of those are mitochondrial, so they are likely to be dead cells. In this other one, we have the number of expressed genes per cell and number of transcripts per cell. So this, you would expect that there would be a relatively good correlation. So in other words, if the number of genes expressed and detected increases, then also the number of transcripts or the UMIs should increase. So far, both these tools I showed are based on the Seurat package. But I would like to point out that there is also another package called Scater, which is very good for quality control. So Scater is a bioconductor package. It has very rich functionality for quality control and visualization of single-cell RNA-seq data. Scater has its own object structure. So the R object that we discussed so far was a Seurat object. Now we have a Scater object, and they are different, but you can give a Seurat object to Scater tools in Chipster, because Chipster takes care of the conversion behind the scenes. So there is a tool, Scater QC, in Chipster. It produces many different kinds of quality plots, and there's a separate video explaining how to interpret them.